In my town, it is officially summer season. The summer school is letting out literally in one day. Everything is happening. It is really becoming such a summer season, and the summer movies is beginning. So now it's time to do my most anticipated for June of 2019, guys. I do this every month, like usual. Three movies I am looking forward to, three movies I am not looking forward to. This is just because of trailers I've seen, stuff I've heard about the movie, just the movies I want to see this month, and three movies I'm not really excited for to see. And at the very end, we get to predict what movie's going to make the most money and what movie's going to flop this entire month. It's a fun little video I do every month, so let's get right into it, guys. Three movies I am looking forward to, and starting with number three. Number three is a movie I think could be one of the best movies of all year, to be honest, and that is a movie called Yesterday. It is Danny Boyle directing, and it's from the writer of Love Actually. And the trailer is just so sweet. It's literally, the story is the Beatles don't exist. He wakes up and he makes their songs, but the Beatles don't exist. So pretty much it's his songs, but really it's the Beatles. The trailer just, it hooked me, and I keep seeing ads for it, and I just want to see it. It looks like good acting. It looks like a good story. It looks original in my opinion. I love Danny Boyle. I think it looks like a good time in the movie theaters, and it looks like a good romance movie that's not just romance. It looks different. So I am very excited to see it. I hope I get to see it because I know it's like a limited kind of movie. All right, so number two. Number two is another movie. So, I will say, I'm excited for this movie, but then again, I could see it suck. But number two is a movie called Annabelle Comes Home. We've all heard about the Annabelle series. This is the third movie in the Annabelle franchise, and obviously the first one we all know sucks. But if you've seen Annabelle Creation, talked about an upgrade in the movie. Annabelle Creation was actually a really good horror film. And so I actually hated The Nun. I did not like The Nun. And Curse of La Llorona, I mean, that was such a throwaway Conjuring movie. So going into this movie, we haven't had the best Conjuring kind of universe movie since Annabelle Creation. And I love Conjuring 1 and 2. And so this one's having the Morrens in this movie. And so I'm really excited to see what they do with it. It is the third Annabelle movie. And next year we get Conjuring 3. So there is some hype in this movie and what they do and how they set up for Conjuring 3. But from the trailers, this movie looks awesome. And I'm hoping it is. Alright, number one. Number one. Some of you might be mad as my number one, but for me personally, I mean, if there's any movie in June I want to see, it's this movie. My number one is for sure Toy Story 4. I mean, I am thinking about doing a trilogy review before seeing Toy Story 4. I'm thinking about doing that, so see for that in the next few weeks or so. But, I mean, I grew up with Toy Story. That was my movie growing up. Like, I mean, I grew up having a Woody toy, a Buzz toy. I collected the toys when I grew up. I love the trilogy. I mean, the third one, this trilogy, there is no bad or okay movie. They're all great movies. Great characters, storytelling, all of it. It is literally top three, top five perfect trilogies in my head. Like, I really think that. This Toy Story trilogy deserves to be talked about. And now going to the fourth one, yeah, it's been 9 years. Obviously, we're all thinking, why are you making a fourth one? The third one ended so good. So I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little worried that we're gonna get Indiana Jones Crystal Skull situation. I don't think we are. It's Pixar. I trust them. I mean, the last time we got a mega flop was like Cars 1 and 2 and 3, basically. And Brave, whatever that was. So going this movie, I'm excited just to see these characters back on the big screen and see the beautiful animation. So again, if I had to say a movie I want to see this month, it's Toy Story without a doubt. Alright, so now we gotta do three movies I'm not looking forward to. And again, these are just from trailer reviews or just what I have heard of. Coming in number three is a movie I actually want to be good. I just don't know what they're gonna do. And number three, I'm sorry to say it. I'm gonna say it, but the remake of Child's Play. I'll say this. When they announced this movie, I could care less. And then I heard the creator, the actual original Child's Play, was like, no, I make my own TV series. Stop remaking my movie. And then I got really nervous. And then finally, I just sat back and I was like, I'm not looking for this movie. Then they announced Mark Hamill was Chuck. And I was like, oh, all right, I'll buy that. Besides that, I could care less about this movie. The trailer didn't do it for me. The first teaser did it. The first teaser, I was like, this looks creepy. This recent trailer, it just, I don't know, there's something cheesy about it. I don't know. It looks like they're trying to do like a Stranger Thing kind of situation. The kids group together to defeat Chucky. I don't know what they're gonna do. I just know that Mark Hamill is gonna kill it. He's gonna kill it as Chucky. That's all there's to it. So it is my number three because, again, besides Mark Hamill, I could care less to see the remake of Child's Play. Alright, number two. Number two is also really sad because I want this movie to be good. And before they announced this movie, when they were announcing the cast and the director, I was like, this sounds awesome. My number two is Men in Black International. Okay, again. Like I said, I'm doing this because of trailers or anything I've heard. This is solely based on the trailers. I have not laughed and I have not enjoyed any of the trailers. Not a single thing has made me laugh or like, that looks awesome. Nothing. Nothing at all. I love Chris Hemsworth. I love Tessa Thompson. Their chemistry in Thor Ragnarok was great. We all know it. That's why they put them in this movie, because of Thor Ragnarok. So in this movie, again, the trailers, nothing has been funny. I've not laughed once. I've not smiled. I could care less right now to see Men in Black. And I don't know. I hope it's good. I hope it's so good that the franchise gets rebooted. Because I like this. Men in Black is such an awesome franchise. Like, at one point, they were going to do 21 Jump Street into Men in Black. That's a great idea. It's kind of dumb, but it could have been a great idea. But they went this route, and so far, from the trailers and the commercials and the promotions, I could care less. All right, so number one. Now, this is the movie I could care less to see. And it's a little sad because I just want, again, I want it to be, I want every movie to be good. But this movie, I don't understand why it matters anymore. And that is, well, I think it's called this, but it's called, for me, X-Men Dark Phoenix. Or is it just called Dark Phoenix? I'm not really sure. But I'm going to say Dark Phoenix. Dark Phoenix is the new X-Men movie, and we already know Disney has already bought 20th Century Fox. The X-Men characters are going to transfer into Marvel Universe, Avengers, all that kind of stuff. We know this. Then what's the point of this movie then? Then why are we getting this movie? Why not just do the Disney streaming service? Why are we getting this movie if all these actors are going to get recast? I don't know, and that really sucks, because again, if the Disney deal didn't happen, I'd be more excited, but from the trailers and the movie being pushed back like twice, I don't know. It's been pushed back twice. Everyone I've talked to has not been excited for this movie, and I just don't feel the hype anymore. Like, ever since Logan, the X-Men franchise has just gone downhill for me, to be honest. That sucks. I mean, not counting Deadpool. Deadpool's amazing. But this, the franchise itself, if this one sucks, I mean, does it matter? Because we're going to get him in the Avengers movie, so I don't understand the purpose of this movie. I'm going in this movie just hoping for a good time, maybe a good ending to these characters. I don't know. I don't know what I'm getting. So that's why my number one is, because I don't know what this movie is. I don't know if I really want this movie. So I was like, you know what? If I say that, then it must be number one. So my number one is Dark Phoenix, unfortunately. All right, so now the fun part of the video that a lot of people have to do. Again, leave a comment down below, leave a prediction for you if you want to do this. What movie is getting most money? What movie is going to flop? So make most money, I think, hands down, Toy Story 4. I was going to say Secret Life of Pets 2. I was going to say that. But it's Toy Story. Adults are going to bring their kids to see Pets. Everyone wants to see Toy Story 4. They want to see, what are they going to do? Like, I mean, that's the fourth one. Obviously, some people are going to boycott it because the trilogy is so perfect. But most people are going to be like, I want to see the next Toy Story. I love the first three. They want to see what is next for these characters. Is this the last Toy Story? Because I think it is. So yeah, Toy Story 4, I do believe, is going to make the most money, even though it comes out June 21st. So it has 2 weeks to make the most money. But I truly believe it has a good shot at making the most money for all the month of June. And the movie's gonna flop. Now, this is really hard because I'm really dumb. I did not look at the production budgets for Dark Phoenix or Men in Black. But those are my two because, again, trailers have not done anything for me, Men in Black. And Dark Phoenix, I don't know a single person right now that is excited or looking forward to the next X-Men movie. So I'm gonna go with my gut and I'm gonna say Men in Black. Alright, and the reason why is because X-Men's a superhero movie. Comic book people go see comic book movies. That's just the kind of no question kind of scenario. But Men in Black, I mean, we got three movies and one of them was really good. The other two suck. So this one's got a reboot the franchise, bring in new characters, and bring new cast. If it does it, the movie can make money. If it don't, this movie is going to tank very hard. And I think from the trailers, it looks like it's going to tank. So that is my flop of the month. So that is it, guys. Those are my most anticipated for June. And the movies, and those movies I think is my most money. Makes me it's going to flop. So leave a comment below. Tell me what you guys think. What movie are you looking forward to? Are you looking forward to Toy Story 4? Or are you looking forward to that zombie movie with Bill Murray that I can't remember the name of that I just remembered? Don't Wake the Dead. Yeah, that looks cheesy. Anyway, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I will see you guys on the next one. Bye-bye, everyone.